The beat is the heart and soul of any music you hear.
Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, put your hands on the radio. It's time for the
Sonia Pessoa. Did I say that right, Sonia?
Sonia Pessoa.
Pessoa. I'm working on my Portuguese. Hey. Well, Sonia's an accomplished samba dancer. Sonia's danced all around the world. Sonia's been dancing for some time. She's appeared in such places as Broadway, the Kennedy Center, the Lincoln Center. She's been everywhere. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to let Sonia tell you a little bit about herself. Sonia, tell me about yourself.
Good afternoon. My name is Sonia Pessoa. I'm from Bahia. State of Brazil, Spain the North, and also the home of Samba. Samba was actually born in Bahia. They came to Bahia with the slaves, so there is an influence of Afro descendants, and when the slave came, actually the name of Samba is called Semba, S-E-M-B-A, which means neighbor. Samba music was a samba dancing, And the way they dance, they should dance in a circle with people clapping. And each person will take a turn to the middle of the center. And when they're done dancing, they will just kind of hit the other person with the name. So it's called Umbigada. And that name is we gave to that samba called Samba de Roda, which means samba in circle. And the samba came from the part of Bahia called the Recôncavo. And many cities like Cachoeira, São Félix, Santa Amaro. And until today, Samba de Roda is still being done. And it's actually, the government has recognized in 2005 as a patrimony, a historical patrimony, or immaterial patrimony, patrimony of Bahia. But with the slaves, when the slaves were in Bahia, some of them had to move to Rio for the coffee plantation. And of course, when they left to Rio, they took the samba with them. And when the samba got to Rio, the samba has to go into some modification. And you know, then you have the samba carioca. The instruments they use in the samba carioca is a little bit different from what we use in samba de roda, even though they have some of the same instruments. But samba de roda use a lot of viola, berimbau, because there is a big connection with samba de roda and the capoeira. The samba familiar, they use pandeiro, they use surdos, they use chocalho. So that is the divergence of a lot of people thinking that samba came from Rio. They think that when the samba went to Rio de Janeiro, and we have all this modification, and most of the artists was from Rio. So Rio became the country of samba, the house of samba. But the history that samba was born in. So the samba from Bahia is called samba de roda. Also we have samba reggae, which is a mixture of samba and reggae from Jamaica. And that samba reggae was actually created by Olodum, which is a group from Bahia who plays samba reggae. We have samba rock. We have samba pagode. You know, so the samba took a dimension that is goes all over the Brazil. São Paulo, Rio, Bahia, Minas. And I guess in Salvador we have samba pagode, we have samba duro. And they all come from the same samba, but they may change some of the instrument or some of the melodies.
So does each type of samba have its own dance, unique dance step?
Kind of, because the samba is a samba. You have the step of the samba, but then the samba de roda, like say we do in a circle, we use most of the hips. Samba duro is almost like samba de roda. It also is heavier, we use a lot of the hips. Samba from Rio de Janeiro, which is the samba that we dance in the samba school. We use a high heel, so it's a more elegant type of samba. Samba rocky, they call samba rocky because they use some the guitar, you know, some of the electronic instruments instead of the percussion instrument. But they're pretty much the same. And samba pagode is a romantic way of dancing samba. It's almost like the gafieira, the dance in a couple.
Oh, okay. Oh. So it's kind of more like a ballroom dance?
It's like a ballroom dance, yes. Even though samba pagode is different from gafieira, but the gafieira is dancing in a couple. Together, so the samba pagode too, but it's more mellow. It's more like a romantic type of samba. Mm.
So is there singing over samba music? Will it be singing? People will be singing?
People will be singing, yes.
Oh, so with the samba, as far as like the samba schools and everything like that, I went to Brazil and I was really impressed by how they prepare for carnival. And they have all the samba schools preparing almost all year for carnival.
All year?
Yeah, and the dancers are part of it. Real important part of that.
It is amazing. Like I said, I'm from Bahia. I have the honor to be in the samba schools. I love samba from Rio. For me, samba is samba. And I can only say that it takes the whole year. You know, they have actually something called Sambódromo, where they have the samba parade. But they have a fabric where they have all the samba schools coming together. Like people who work like they work 8 to 5. It's a job. Take the whole year to prepare all those carros allegóricos, you know, the big flutes, the costumes. So yeah, people prepare for the whole year. The same thing in the carnival, it takes the whole year to prepare, to do the abadás, the new rehearsal. So it's something that you wait the entire year for the celebration. You know? It's when you really get, I think, feel like the sense of being free, you know, to go out, to dance. And the Carnival in Salvador is amazing. It's the whole week of celebration. And, you know, you go to the street, you don't need to actually, you can pay to get inside of a blockus or to go to a VIP, but you can be right there also in the street for the entire week. And that goes from 11 a.m. to the next day, 5 a.m. So if you have the energy to go out and dance and have fun, it's
beautiful. That sounds like fun.
It is fun. And especially when you see all the blockers, the Afro blockers, you know, you have the Ashe, you have the Afro Chess, you know, and again, the difference is more in the style of the music. The Afro Chess, the Afro, the Ashe. We don't have a summer school in Salvador, not during the Carnival. So most of for us would be the two electrical, which is the big chalk with the singers and the musician on top. And we have the Afro Chess and the Afro. No. So you have to go to Salvador for the Carnival. I always say that Carnival is something that everybody has to do at least once in their lifetime. It's an experience, to really know what we're talking about. Because I can come here. So when we dance, the way you move your feet, you're doing three steps and two beats of the music. So you're gonna use one, two, three. So you actually using the whole foot down, you're using the toes, the ball, and the heel of the foot. So this is how you're gonna do it, almost like if you have a bubble gum in your feet and you try to take it out. So actually it's sliding. A lot of people, you hop, so you have to make sure that you're not really doing the little hop, the little jump, but just stepping one, two, three, one, two, three. So when you get there and you're using the muscle of your tibia, so you're pretty much using, not your knee, you're not really bending your knee, but you're using the muscles of your inner thigh, and also the tibia to move your feet and transfer from one side to the other. It's almost like a walking, right? When you walk, you transfer the weight from one leg to the other, but what you're gonna do with the samba, you're gonna transfer there, but you're also using your feet, you're stepping three times. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. But that you make easier once you use your hips. The way you use your hips in samba is almost like you're sitting in one leg. Right? So if you walk back, every time you walk back, you shift the weight from one leg to the other. This way. So for the samba, you're gonna bounce twice. One and two, one and two, one and two. And you, it's almost like if you put it one hip under the other hips. Right? So you're not pushing to the side, it's not like a pop. It's really a tuck, you're tucking one hip under the other. So you bounce it twice, one and two, one and two. If you walk back, you walk and you bounce twice, and then you change your leg, walk and you bounce twice. Like, you can try to do that if you're walking. Pretend you walk on the street normally, and you cannot walk the normal flow, and you're walking and you're bouncing. So that, when you bounce on your hips twice, one, two, and one, and two, one, and two, and one, and two, and you, at the same time, you're gonna be moving your feet. So your feet's gonna be doing one, two, three, but the second step's actually that, so you're not really counting that. You know that your feet is stepping three times, but you're just really using the fourth and the third step. So one and two, one and two, and your feet will do one, two, three, one, two, three. Your arms is gonna come from your navel, right? And any dance that you do, your elbow has to be the first one coming. So your elbow is gonna be the one coming out first. Then your wrist and your shoulder is gonna be the last one. Right? So you're gonna drop your arm to the same level of your nose. When your left arm is coming to your navel, your right arm is gonna go up. And you can do an eight counts. Right? You You can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You can also do in 4 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Of course, if you do faster, if you do less count, you're going to have to move your arm faster. But the key here is your elbow. It should be the one. And you have to elongate your arms all the way up. It's very easy to do this here. Some people come and they just break the arm between the level of shoulder. You don't want to do that. You want to do the whole circle all the way up and bring. Another thing you don't want to do, you do not want to cross over your head. So you always bring your arm to the center of your pose.
Technical in terms of posture, you know, you're using your shoulder, your arms, and your hips, and your feet at the same time. The samba from Rio, pretty much, you just slide, you swing your feet side side. So your legs are open instead of the samba from V, which your legs are closed, going front and back. This one, you can open your leg a little bit wider than your hips. Actually, the same length of your shoulder, right? And you're pretty much sliding side, 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 side. So the feet is pretty easy, okay? How you do with the hips? The hip is gonna be the same thing. You like pushing, almost like you're pushing a door, a half door with your hips. So side, side, one, two, three, four. So you sway your hips and your feet side, side. And your hands coming also side, okay? You can use your shoulders in almost like a half a circle. But pretty much your hands are free, side, side. And the key here is to push your hips to the right and to the left.
Thank you. watching?
TV.
What are you watching?
TV.
What are you watching?
TV.
What are you watching?
TV.
Yeah.
The beat is the heart and soul of any music you hear. The beat is the heart and soul of any music you hear.